I love what I do because it keeps me outside in the summer in the nice warm weather, but also outside during storms and feeling accomplished, like putting somebody's power back on after a 24-hour storm. My name is Bethany Locke, and I'm a Block 2 Powerline Technician Apprentice. To pursue this career, I've overcome a lot of obstacles, from being told I'd never do what my coworkers or classmates have done, that women don't belong in construction trades. In school, it was a bit nerve-wracking, but I think the more people told me I couldn't do it, or like the boys were kind of like doing it better than me, I just wanted to like prove a point and beat them at it, so like I just worked extra hard. In my trade, some skills that are very important would be being determined and headstrong. You gotta want to like what you do and put your best foot forward every single day and not let other people at work intimidate you and kind of make you feel like you can't achieve what they can achieve. I didn't have a mentor of my own, but I did have other women in trades that I looked up to and aspired to be like. And after I had been out of work for a while, I contacted the women in trades and they helped me obtain 2 full-time careers after college. And at work, like, we had to do a practical interview to start work there. So for the interview, I was really nervous because I'd worked in construction, but I didn't climb a whole lot of poles, or like not like as high. Well, the poles were taller, but I didn't climb that high. I probably only climbed 20 feet every day that I climbed. So I wasn't used to that kind of work anymore, the distribution. And then I didn't realize you had to like put a cross arm up and put a glass up and put these big grounds up. So we went and I was pretty nervous. And I climbed up and this guy tied my cross arm on wrong. So I just took the big cross arm and kind of flicked it around myself and pulled and put it in. And when I got down, the guy who's my general foreman now, he's like, "Wow, we're so amazed by you with your upper body strength." And I was like, "Yeah, I'm here to like win. Like, I'm gonna beat out all the guys here if I can." And just stuff like that. Like, I wasn't gonna let him ruin my interview by sending down the cross arm and him tying it back on. So I was just kind of like watching everybody else and like things that people struggle with. And I was like, I'm going to go up there, I'm going to learn from their little mistakes I'm watching, and I'm going to do it even better. So everybody thinks once you come out of trade school now, it's all buckets and, you know, you get on with the utility in the city where everything is truck accessible, but it's not. So people get the false idea that you're going to come in out of school, you're going to just get into one of these jobs because your uncle, your dad, your brother, your, you know, somebody works at that company, you're just gonna breeze into the company, use a bucket truck for the rest of your career and not actually have to climb. I definitely think women can do this job as well as men, sometimes even better. I feel like you've got to want this, you gotta love it, which I do, and just know that, you know, don't give up. People struggle every day, but you just gotta keep putting your best foot forward and not let people get you down, no matter how much they try to tell you that women don't belong in construction or that you'll never do what other people can do. Just take it one day at a time and do the best you can do. And there's always a beautiful view from every pole.